Everybody.
Is that my little Skylar twittering out there?
Yes, it is.
And when did my squirrel come home?
Just now, Torvald. Come see what I just bought.
After the new year. Until then, we should be a bit more careful.
Well, aren't you sure? You know I could work too.
She's being the same little featherhead again. Right, okay, let's imagine. Suppose you started to work. What kind of job would you get? A mini job. A mini job because you have no qualifications, no experience, 3 children. And what about the 3 children? We would have to hire your childminder, not just a video pair like Marie, and that would cost us a fortune, and the children would suffer from that.
Don't say such horrid things.
Fine, but still, suppose the children would develop some kind of insecurity feeling, thing, whatever these things are called. Yeah, and we would have to hire psychiatrists to deal with the lack of a mother. What then?
Well, many mothers work now, you know.
And they ruin their reputation. Yeah. What then? Really, what would people think?
People? Who would bother about them?
Seriously, Nora, you know what I think about these things. There can be no joy or pleasure in having two working parents. That's not the straight path. And we, the two of us, proudly took the straight path, no matter what happened. And it will remain that way.
As you please, Donald.
What's that? Huh? Is my little squirrel out of her temper? Huh? Has she paid a little visit to the bakery? Maybe? Is that it?
Hmm? No,
not even a little bite at the macaron or two?
No, Donald, I assure you, I didn't.
You know, I'm just kidding. Anyway.
Yes. Besides, I know you prefer a thinner woman.
And you gave me your word. You know, I'm feeling so good that all the hardships of our life are over now. You two will have more time for yourself now, for the children, for the household. And we are going to live in comfort. It's actually more than comfort. It's going to be luxury. You know, the real pleasure of life. Asparagus and pain de foie gras every day. And even macarons and cannelés.
Yes, yes, and oysters, even good for my diet.
Oysters, that goes without saying.
And chocolate and champagne and cigars and champagne and...
I'm Marie, the au pair. I've spent a lovely afternoon. I've been to cinema with a man, and then I also watched a movie with some woman. And after that, we went home, we read the newspaper, and we had brandy with milk. You know what's lovely? Madam, there's a lady to see you, a stranger.
Please, let her in.
Okay.
I still have a lot of work to do. Just let me know. Let me know once dinner's ready, right?
Of course. How do you do, Nora?
How do you do?
You don't recognize me, I suppose.
No. Yes, Christine.
Yeah.
Christine Linde, yeah. Is that you?
Yes, it is I.
Oh, how have you altered, my dear?
Yes, in 9, 10 long years.
Oh, has it been that long? Okay, so you don't live in our hometown anymore, and you've been moving around a lot, and you divorced?
Yes, 3 years ago.
Oh, thing. I'm so sorry. I saw it online and I never took the time to text you and ask you how I was going since then. I'm so sorry.
I quite understand, Nora, dear.
It was really bad of me. Please forgive me. How much you have suffered. So, he left you nothing?
No.
Not any children?
No.
So nothing at all?
Not even any sorrow, but enough about me. I heard you had 3 lovely children, yeah. And your husband just got a promotion, hasn't he?
Yes, he has been made bank manager. We've had a great piece of luck.
Oh, what great luck indeed.
Yes, we're very pleased. He's gonna take his new post in the new year, gonna have lots of commissions and shares. We may live quite different now. I'm so happy, I'm relieved.
Nora and Christine are now too happy to be able to hear me. I can therefore let you in on a little secret. Nora is not Nora, firstly because she is embodied by an actress. She gives you the impression that she wants you to have on her. Nora has one white eye and one red eye. Whereas Nora has one left white eye and one red right eye, Nora has one red left eye and one white right eye. I got it, yeah. Thus, all of your old system of deduction collapses when it comes against this last obstacle which destroys your whole theory. It is in vain that she thinks she is Nora. It is in vain that even she thinks she is Nora. It is in vain that you think she is Nora. Yeah. You believe in vain that she is Nora, and she believes in vain that she is Nora. But who is the true Nora? Who has any interest in prolonging this confusion? I don't know. You know, let's not try to know. Let's leave things as they are. By the way, Nora just explained how Troupe all worked. Burned out and finally needed a cure to recover from capitalism and the race of high productivity. The shortfall of his incomes plus the higher cost of his cure cost him a lot of money. And now, Nora shares her most precious secret. She saved Torvald's life and his reputation. They officially got the money from Nora's father, who just passed away a few days before the cure's beginning. She procured the money alone, told everybody Torvald was suffering from back pain, and kept the secret.
A man who has such strong opinions about these things, and besides, how painful and humiliating it would be for Torvald to know that he owed me anything. would destroy our relations altogether, and our beautiful, happy home would no longer be what it is now.
Christine, as a teenager, has a sick mother, and therefore chains herself early to the many jobs precarity. Marries her ex-husband and his full-time job. A short-time security because he finally earned a fortune, got himself the best lawyer, and beyond earth than a woman fits together, right? Precarity is bad, a one-year job, a hard-fought contract, a second one, and so on. You know, 3 years that rather fell like one long working day with no rest.
My poor mother doesn't need me anymore.
But now the emptiness. No one to take care of anymore. I'll let you guess why she came here to the new bank's director's wife. Nobody wants to guess. Also, my real name is Sherlock Holmes.
You know, it's almost impossible to get a normal contract once you enter the hard score system. Only good luck and connections may help.
Yes, but you're gonna let Torvald find you a new job. It will make me really happy to help you. Yes,
of course. Excuse me, madam. There is a man to see Mr. Helmer, and as you told me, has a lot of work, so what should I do?
Who is it?
It is I, Miss Helmer.
Nils, Krogstad. Both ladies know him.
You? When do you want to see my husband again?
Bank business, in a way. I have a small post at the bank, and I hear your husband is to be our chief.
Bank means money, and money means trouble!
So it is.
Nothing but dry business matters in summer. I assure you, nothing else.
Who would believe a thief?
Then be as good as to go into the study, then.
Nora, who was that man?
A development, management, developer, business man from Towards Bank of the name of Krogstad.
Ha! A swindler, guilty of gambling with bank funds. Blech, don't you smell of that moral corruption?
That it really was him.
There was no other solution than sideline him. Frozen out the thief and put into some safe positions where supervisors can keep an eye on him. You know, this tactic is often used to destroy these disturbing elements, avoiding this way scandal and generous redundancy pay.
Do you know them all?
I used to many years ago.
You imagine, hey, you imagine how good she knew him.
He has greatly altered.
He made a very unhappy marriage.
That's why he actually started gambling.
So he has divorced now too, hasn't he?
With several children.
Ah, he carried on various kinds of business. But who cares?
He never gave me a good impression anyways, and now he's gonna be under Stovold's command. You cannot imagine how glorious it is to know that he's gonna have such power over so many people. I am perfectly happy and everything's perfect. Marie, now that you're here, what do you say to a macaroon?
I mean, I thought they were forbidden here, but of course.
Yes, but these are ones that you did brought for me.
What?
How would you have known that they were for me? I have to tell you. I was afraid it would spoil my teeth and fatten my figure, but once in a while.
Every once in a while.
Have we got rid of him?
Oh yes, he just left.
Let me introduce you. This is Christine.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
You are a high school friend of my beloved wife, I suppose.
Yes, indeed.
Christine is very clever. She was the best pupil in our class, especially at bookkeeping. And she's frightfully anxious to work under some clever man so as to perfect herself.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's a very sensible thing to do, Mrs. Zane.
Yes, and when she found out that you had been made bank manager, she came as soon as she could. I'm certain you'll be able to find something for her, for my sake.
Well, the thing is not altogether impossible. Now, do you have a family, Mrs. Zane, children?
No.
That's interesting. And do you have maybe any experience with bookkeeping?
Yes, a fair amount.
Yeah, that's actually very likely that I can find something for you.
Okay.
You
how
just
you?
Came at a fortunate moment, Mrs. Linde.
How am I to thank you?
There is no need, but now you will both have to excuse me. It's just an hour, not more.
You're leaving too.
Yes. Thank you, Nora, dear, and I will let you know when we can meet again. Yes.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Mommy!
There they are!
Come along, this house will only be bearable for a for a mother.
Since truth comes out of the mouths of babes, we are here to say some truths about Nora's daily life.
We may say I'm Nora's conscience, her ego.
And I would be her guilty conscience, so to say, the little voice in her head who controls her actions, to keep her from doing anything bad, unconsidered socially. I would be her superego.
And I would be the temptation, the mean voice, the id, that tries to corrupt our gentle Nora. I am her secret desires and her evil thoughts.
I am Nora, Torvald's wife. A mother of three, I'm young and beautiful. I love to dance for my husband. Torvald bought a beautiful dolly house. I love it when he cares for me. I love to care for him and my kids.
Well, I would love to. Your reputation, your ring of friends is simply outstanding. You have the perfect life, dear. It's all mother and father ever dreamt for you. It's all you ever wanted.
If I could!
What for? To lose your husband, your children? Without them, you would be nothing.
Working is not such a big deal. I would finally be recognized as an active, clever, seductive woman.
But you are already active, and clever, and seductive.
The housewife life. Active with an auto. I love to eat macarons and enjoy my power over my kingdom. I'm a princess. I'm a queen. I'm an empress!
But no, emperor. That means you're nothing. You're a belly for the emperor's children. You're also the strength and treasure of your husband. He would conquer the world for you. You share everything.
Except freedom! Okay, you can hide from the truth, but I'll eventually come out and find you.
You didn't find me!
Mommy!
Excuse me, Mrs. Helmer. This is something quite different indeed. I presume you have a moment. I just saw your husband leave with a lady.
Yes, Christine Linde, a dear friend of mine. And once of yours, I heard.
So she told you about us. So you know. Well, then I can ask without beating around the bush, is Miss Linde to have the job in the bank?
How dare you question me like that, you one of my husband's subordinates? Yes, Christine is to have a job, and it was I who pleaded her cause, let me tell you that. When someone is in a position of subordination, they should really be careful to avoid offending anyone who
has influence.
Exactly.
Mrs. Helmer, you'll be so good as to use your influence for my benefit.
Excuse me?
You'll be so good to use your influence to make sure that I don't lose my subordinate position.
What do you mean by that?
Please, Mrs. Helmer, there's no need to keep up this pretense of ignorance.
But, Mr. Crockett, I have no influence.
Really? I thought you said yourself just now.
I'm not afraid of you any longer. As soon as the new year comes, I will be free of the whole thing.
Listen, Mrs. Helmer, if necessary, I'm willing to fight for my position in the bank as if I were fighting for my life.
So it seems.
Money is the least of my concerns. I suppose you know, like everyone else, that many years ago I was found guilty with gambling with the bank's funds.
I think I've heard something of the kind.
The matter never came into court, but after that, every way seemed closed to me. I accepted the measly proposition that the bank gave me. It was like a first step up for me. Now your husband is ready to kick me back downstairs again into the mud.
Mr. Krogstad, I have no power to help you at all.
Then that's because you haven't the will. But I have the means to compel you.
You wouldn't tell my husband about our little arrangement.
Now suppose I did tell him.
That would be infamous of you. To think of he learning my secret that has been my joy and pride in such an ugly, clumsy way that he would learn it from you. And it would put me in a horribly disagreeable position.
Not only disagreeable?
Well, do it then. Then there will be worse for you, because he will see by himself what a blackguard you are. You certainly won't keep your post then.
Mrs. Helmer, when your husband became ill, you came to me for money to repay your husband's cure. I accepted a monthly progress repayment, which you honored regularly.
I didn't know anyone else to go to.
Necessity may be the mother of invention, Mrs. Helmer, but precipitation is the father of hidden intentions. You know, I've been in this business a while. You're so concerned with Torvald's back pain that I didn't need much time. Some research, a little bit of hacking, and in less than an hour, I knew the true reason behind Torvald's cure.
I don't know what you're talking about.
No what? With me, please! Our beloved Torvald couldn't stand the pressure of the bank, and so he burned out. What would say his new colleagues? Or his subordinates, as you like to call them? Or even worse, his superiors? What would they think of a woman who works illegally? Who abandons her children regularly to meet with a man who lives on his own while her husband suffers from a burnout? Or, who knows? A depression caused by an illegitimate affair? How could a woman like her make so much money? A woman with no experience, but with such a beautiful body.
These are lies! No one would believe you! You're losing your time!
Are you sure? Which version of the story do you prefer? The one with you as the poor, shameful mother with a weak, powerless spouse? Or the one with you as the femme fatale, with an impotent husband?
Nobody would care about Tolu's private life. And besides, the repayment should be finished in a few months and...
Ms. Helmer, why didn't you go and work like any other woman? Why didn't you work legally like any other woman?
Because Tolu would have never allowed it. Would have rather started working again rather than seeing me help him or the children. Would have died before I loved it. It was impossible.
Miss Helmer, you clearly don't realize the situation that you're in. These men, they don't care about your motives. nor your intentions or your explanations. The only thing that they want is fresh meat. Some illegal or illegitimate business, something to stimulate their catharsis.
Well, they must be foolish, this man.
Foolish they may be, but they have the power. They write the law by which you will be judged.
I don't believe that. Is a wife not allowed to see her husband's life? I don't know much about law, but I'm certain there must be something permitting such things as that.
Maybe. But in business, such as the business that you and I have had together, men have a power. Not respecting the law could mean that you lose everything. Well, I've said my piece. But let me say this. If I lose my position a second time, I'll make sure you lose yours with me.
Nonsense. Trying to frame me like that. I'm not as silly as he thinks in the end. I did it for the love's sake. I've always followed the recipe. Never let my caramel burn. Never transport my claim to daughter. I always paid attention to proportions, to the mise en forme, the mise en scène, and mise en bouche. The taste of others. Voila, an objective that deserves attention. That's why everybody loves macaroons. I mean, they're soft, round, and cute. There's one for everybody's taste. They bend to the whim and the desire of the commander. It goes well with so personable. But in the end, it lost its personality. And it's special. It's classy, although it's finally banal. It certainly takes a lot of time to prepare. The shape has to be perfect. It has to fit in. Be good. Be beautiful. Please. Conform to your kind. We take a bite out of them. They are the glamorous snack with the coffee. We almost forget about it. It's nice if it's there. If not, it's not a big deal. Did you know it? The macaron refers only to the famous sweet shells. It gave its name to the whole pastry. The macaron took over the cream, and yet, the cream. We all agree on this, I am sure, is the most interesting part of the macaron. If it gives flavor to the cookie, so to say, its personality. In order to ensure a good balance, we have to be sure not to put too much cream in it. If not, the little devil will conduct runovers. Fortunately, trapped. We press it. We hide it between two standard shells with attracting and pleasing colors. Kind of nice. But be careful. If you put too much cream in it and you bite it too toughly or too vigorously, the cream will escape. The fragile almond straitjacket won't hold the cream back. The tired macaron won't hold it, and then the cream will sooner or later get the upper hand and it will flow like tears and wine. And the long, calm river called life.
Hi, Bobby.
Hi, Dad.
You wanna go for a ride?
Sure.
Jump in.
I'm a Bobby girl. In the Bobby world, black and plastic, it's fantastic. You can brush the hair, undress me everywhere. Imagination, life is your creation.
Come on, Barbie, let's go party.
Yeah.
Balthazar.
Are you sure those are the names of the three kings?
I really prefer Ishmael, it sounds better.
I want to play something else. I know, Mom and Dad.
I tell you the truth. Whoever hears my word and believes him who has sent me has eternal life and shall not be condemned. He has crossed over from death to life. So now, obey me. I am the head of household.
Okay, okay, but what do you want me to be then?
The head of every man is Christ, and that of every woman is man, and that of Christ is God. Be my wife and obey all my orders.
What about me?
Older women are to teach what is good, and so train the young women to love their husbands and children, to be kind, pure, working at home, and submissive to their own husbands. You are to be our wife, our child, raised to carry on my eternal life cycle.
And then they lived happily ever after.
So, this Krogstad came here again, and you hid it from me, and you start negotiations with him, bargaining, accepting his little offers. You know, Nora, the worst thing is that you lied to me.
Lied?
Yes, yes, you lied to me. Don't you think hiding such an important fact is quite the same as lying?
My precious little Skylark must never do that again, right? A Skylark has to have a clean beak to chirp with, no false notes. Right, I should really get some work done, darling. I need to undertake the necessary changes in the staff before I become everyone's chief.
Yes, yes, but Tomon, was it really such a bad thing that this Krogstad was guilty of?
Such a bad thing? Well, you know, he gambled too much with bank funds. Do you even know what that means?
But isn't it possible that he did it out of necessity, or...?
Yes, according to some, he was pressurized. He was trying to keep his wife by earning a higher bonus or such thing. Well, he was acting foolishly because he precipitated. You know that I'm not such a cruel man to condemn somebody for one false step of this kind. You know that.
Yes, no. You wouldn't, would you, Torvald?
But this Krogstad has never openly confessed what he had done. He never took his punishment. He got himself out of it by a little cunning trick, which is why he was rightfully put aside by his superiors.
Do you think it wouldn't?
Just think, Nora, just think how a liar like this has to play the hypocrite in front of everyone, in front of those near and dear to him, even his family, his wife, his children. You know, this is the worst part of it, Nora, the children.
How?
Well, just imagine how those children grow up in an atmosphere poisoned by lies and dishonesty. Every breath those children take is filled with the germs of evil.
Are you sure of that?
Yes, no, just believe me, I have seen this throughout my career. Whenever a young person takes the wrong path early on, it's somehow coming from the parents. It's like, you know, the bad influence of their mother or these things.
Why do you only say mothers?
Yes, yes, most typically it seems to be the mother's fault, though. Yeah, obviously a bad father would have the same influence. Now, this Krogstad is constantly poisoning his children with lies and dissimulation, and that is why I say he has lost all his moral credibility in my eyes. And that is why my precious little squirrel must promise never to plead his cause again. Give me your hands on it. What's that? Give me your hands. Great. Now let's settle. I really couldn't work with such a horrible man anyways. Just believe me, I feel physically ill when I have to be in the company of those people. Yeah, you know.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. I am so full of energy. I'm so excited for tomorrow's party, and yeah, that's all I can think about now.
Yes, me too. Yes, I should really get some work done, darling. Later, we can also choose a fancy party dress for my precious little singing bird.
Children, please.
Ibsen. My home. It's not gonna be possible.
Summarize the long conversation we both two were having. Wait, I know. So, y'all can see me. So, I know. So, this is Nora. Ah, beautiful and innocent, a sweetheart. And this is Mrs. Linde, older, I mean, in terms of fashion, more serious but still gentle. You know, Barbie dolls are gentle anyways. Yeah. I found this costume for the party at the Sternbergs who live above us. Torvald had it made for me. Torvald, blah, 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 blah. He loves me. He wants me to wear it and so on. But now, it is also torn and the party is tomorrow night. And I haven't any idea. Could you fix it? We will easily put that right. But now, tell me more about your problems of money. How much have you been able to pay off in that way? I can't tell you exactly. You see, it's very difficult to keep an eye on a business matter of that kind, with quarterly interest, payment, and installments. So, how then? How did you pay it back? Have you found some rich admirer? A lover? Of course not! You're just like the others. They all think that I'm incapable of anything really serious. So, how then? How did you pay it back? You see, I'm engaged
pay a bit every month. I just had to save a little here, a little there, as much as I could, you know. I only know that I could, that I paid every penny that I could scrape together. Admit that it sounds unbelievable. Who lent you the money? Whoosh! There's Torvald come home! Hide with Marie and the children! We'll talk afterwards! No, I'm not going anywhere until we've talked about it, darling. I've wanted you so much, Torvald, dear!
Hello, sir.
Oh. Yes, yes, just look at all this. I'm coming from the bank.
But if you're a little spirit, we're just asking for anything. And she asked really, 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 and she did all the things she said she liked to do. Would you do it, Torvald, for my sake? Dear Torvald?
My scroll should speak if she doesn't want to get me nuts.
I expected that. Not scroll.
Nora, do you want me to ask? Do you want to ask me again to keep Krogstad in my team? Told! Yes, I beg you so earnestly! No fucking way! No fucking way! He's not a good man. It's incredible how obstinate you are about this. Anyway, his post shall be arranged for Mrs. Linde. Nora? Are you afraid for me? Is that it? You fear this evil man? But don't be, my dear. We were once very... We were once very intimate friends. But it can't last. He's not accepting hierarchy, my superior position. His moral failings only stand here for his weakness of mind. You know, it can't last. I must put an end to this. I must put an end to this.
Yes, I must. Yeah, yes. Yeah. What's happening here?
I better join the children.
I am settling this, Miss. A little obstinate.
What are you writing?
Mr. Krogstad, dismissal.
No, Torvald. You don't have to do that. Just think about it. Do it for you. Do it for the children, Torvald. Do it for me, Torvald. Are you listening to me?
Too late.
Oh, yes. Yes, it's too late.
I can forgive your anxiety. Although really it is an insult to me. It is indeed. Isn't it an insult to think that I should be afraid of a starving queer driver's vengeance? But I forgive you, nevertheless, because it is such eloquent witness to your great love for me. And that is as it should be, my own darling Nora. Come what will, you may be sure I shall have both the courage and the strength if they be needed. You will see that I am man enough to take everything upon myself. Well, we will share it, Nora, as a man and a wife should. That is how it shall be.
No, nothing rather than... You know...
I suppose.
I fought as hard as I could in your side, but it was no good.
Does he love you so little?
What do you want? I can't pay you back right now.
That doesn't matter. I want a new deal. An amicable arrangement. The whole thing could remain a secret between us three.
will not tell my husband about this.
You know you're not alone in this. I have made up my mind and nothing can change it. I prepared an email with all the information of our arrangement and all the proofs.
No, don't send him. I'll find a solution. I'll pay you back.
I'm not asking for a penny.
What do you want then?
I want a higher position. I want Torvald to make a position, especially for me, in the bank.
He will never do it.
And he will do. For reasons that both you and I know. Have you forgotten these reasons? Well, I've warned you. But let me say this. It is Torvald personally who has forced me into ways such as this again. And for that, I'll never forgive him.
Have to happen.
Okay, Nora. I will go at once and see Krogstad.
And you just hide Torvald's phone, tell him it has bad consequences on health, libido, appetite, whatever. I will soon be back.
All electronic devices! But darling, I need to stay connected, at least professionally, to keep up to date with reality.
Save your friend at any cost.
Nils, a woman that sells ask herself once for another man's sake, doesn't do it again.
I will delete the email.
No, Nils, no! You must not delete the email.
But I thought that's what you wanted to meet me for.
At the first moment of fright it was, but now that I look at the situation from another angle, Helmer must know all about it. This unhappy secret must be disclosed. The couple should face concealment and falsehood going on here. But, Nils, you must go now. The party's over. We're not safe here any longer.
All right. I'll wait for you by the corner.
Yes, do. Someone and something to work for. A home to bring comfort into. I can't wait.
Minute more, remember that was our agreement. All right, come in, you'll catch a cold outset.
Good evening.
Good evening, Mrs. Linde, you're here so late.
Oh, you must excuse me. I just couldn't go without seeing Nora in her dress, and I came too late, so I just waited for you.
Well, I suppose you can take a good look at her now. I think she is really worth taking a good look at. Right. Do you think she's particularly charming to the
musician? Yes, indeed.
Everyone thought at the dance too. She was a tremendous success. But unfortunately, she's also terribly self-willed a little darling. What are we to do with her?
You will regret not letting me stay half an hour more, darling.
Just listen to that, Mrs. Schindler. Do you think I was going to let her stay after that marvelous success and ruin the effect? No. An exit should always be effective. That's what I always say. You know, as they say in the novel, the beautiful apparition disappear. This is what I can't get her sweetest Nora to understand.
Well, I had a talk with him.
Yes, and
as far as Krogstad is concerned, you have nothing to worry about, but you must tell Torvald.
No, I won't tell him.
Then the email will. Okay.
Yes, I know what I have to do.
You look beautiful.
So, Mrs. Linde, have you admired her?
Yes, and I will leave you two now. Goodbye, Nora, and don't be so self-willed anymore.
That's very right, Mrs. Linde. Well, I would really walk you home, but I know you live so close anyway, and you're a strong, independent woman, right? So, yeah, you will get home safe.
Yes.
And yes,
thank
I
you.
Hope you do. Yes,
thank
have a good
night.
Night. Sleep
Nora,
tight.
Good night.
Yes.
Goodbye, Mr.
It was such a pleasure. Have a good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Thank you.
Finally, we've gotten rid of her. She's such a frightful, bored woman, isn't she, my darling Nora?
Aren't you tired, Torvald?
On the contrary.
Nor sleepy?
Not the slightest. I feel extraordinarily lively.
Look at me like that tonight, Torvald.
Why am I not supposed to look at my dearest treasure? The beauty that is mine and all my very own.
No, you cannot speak to me like that tonight.
You know, when we go out to these parties, with her, I have a little game. You know, do you know why? Why it is that I don't even stay with you and I don't talk to you all the time? I just share stolen glance every now and then. That's because I make believe to myself that we are secretly in love and that you are my secret passionate lover, and all the others in the room don't even have a clue that something is going on between us.
Yes, I know your thoughts are with me all the time.
Oh, yes, all the time. In fact, all this evening I have longed for nothing but you, and I couldn't endure it anyway. That's the real reason why I had to take you home so early. To me, and only to me.
I cannot.
You must be joking,
no.
My little nerd. Am I not your husband? I'm your husband, and
Sometimes I feel I couldn't hold him tight enough. I feel like I wish some great danger would threaten you just so that I can show to the whole world that I'm ready to defend you and to risk everything, my life, for your sake.
Domo, just catch up with reality.
One is the quarter life, one becomes one.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Dolly Spirit.
Two wrongs don't make a right.
You're the mom and you the child. I am your father.
Spare the rote and spoil the child.
Die rabe Mutter, the raven mother, the unworthy wife, the shameful mother who abandons her inherited tasks for her own career and selfish desire, doesn't take into account her children's visceral needs.
Inspired by the sound to tease around the children's necks so that they can go home alone, the Rabenmutter is followed by the shrill bad conscience.
Every bird must hatch her own eggs.
Mother doesn't work because it would apparently be bad for me, the child.
For us all, as a family, as a couple, as a social entity.
If I work, we'll have to choose between his salary and mine. One of us will be taxed a lot. Another one, almost nothing. It's how it works in Germany. Which one should be texted then? The lowest. Mine, of course.
Don't bite the hand that feeds you. Mothers are encouraged not to work. They don't work because they don't earn much. So there are few childcare facilities. No childcare facilities, no choice, so less female labor. Less female labor, no integration into the labor market, so reproduction of inequalities. Reproduction of inequalities means gender wage gap.
Welcome to our vicious circle.
One woman's trash is another man's treasure.
Since 2012, the German state offers 150 euros to every mother who can let their child age from 1 to 3 years old into the state childcare system. Rather than financing the state nurseries to help women into their professional life, the state prefers to have housewives stay at home by increasing 50% of their state aid.
All good things must come to an end.
Dear Abendmutter, you can't make an omelet without breaking a few of your eggs.
No work and no play makes Nora a dull girl.
Nora, what is this?
Children should be seen, not heard.
What? Is it true that I read here? No, it's impossible. It can't be true, right?
It is true. I loved you above everything else in the world, Tommy.
Really? Really? How can you be? Just how can you be so remiss?
Just let me go. You shouldn't have to say to me.
No tragic airs, please. Here you shall stay and give me an explanation. Do you understand what you have done? Answer me, do you understand what you have done?
Yes. I begin to understand.
8 years I have loved this woman above everything. She was my joy and my pride. And she's a hypocrite and a liar. And now, she's putting me into the hands of an unscrupulous man who can order me around as he pleases. And who am I to refuse? I will sink to miserable depths all because of a thoughtless woman. Do you know that you have destroyed all my happiness? That you have ruined my future?
When I am out of your way, you shall be free.
No fine speeches, please. Just answer me. How would that make any good? If you're out of the way, and you say, not this life, that's because Krogstad can make the affair, your affair, known everywhere, anyway. No, one thing will matter now, from now on, and that's very simple. The reputation. To keep up appearances.
Cleanliness is next to godliness.
It must appear in the eyes of the world that everything between us is just as it was before, but naturally only in the eyes of the world. To think that even a few minutes ago I was loving and hugging and kissing that woman so dearly. That has to come to an end. All that matters now is to save what remains. What is this? Nora! No, wait, I have to read it again. Yes, Nora, it is true. Look, Nora! I'm saved, Nora! I am saved! Yes, you are safe too. Yeah, just look what he says. He says he regrets and repents. His a happy change occurred in his life. Never mind what he says. He says we are saved. Nora, the whole thing will just be a bad dream to me. Look, you know what? I will delete the whole thing. See? It doesn't exist anymore.
Better late than never?
What's that? Nora, you don't seem to realize that the whole thing really is all over. My poor little Nora. I quite understand you. You must find it hard to believe that I will really forgive you everything. But it is true, Nora, I forgive you because I know that all you did out of love for me.
That is true. The cobbler's children go barefoot.
You loved me as a wife ought to love her husband. Only you didn't know the conditions of the world or the consequences of your actions. But just lean on me and I will guide you through this dangerous world. You won't have to worry. Yeah, you shouldn't worry about the harsh things I might have said in my first moments of despair. Here I am, Nora, ready to forgive you.
Thank you for your forgiveness.
No, don't go. What are you doing there?
Taking off my fancy clothes and makeup. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder.
Oh, yes, do that. Yes, just make yourself comfortable and calm and easy again and be at rest and feel secure because, you know how they say, I have my broad wings to shelter you under. You know, you can't even imagine how indescribably sweet it feels for me as a man to have forgiven my wife freely and with all my heart. It feels like if I had made you doubly mine by that, I have given you a new, more peaceful life and everything.
We have a lot to say to one another.
Where is that? This poor sad face.
Please. We have a lot to say.
You alarm me, Nora. I don't understand you.
No. No, you don't understand me. And I have never understood you either. Not until tonight. No. Just listen. You have never loved me. You only found it pleasing to be in love with me.
Nora, what do I hear you saying?
It's perfectly true, Tobo. I always looked for your approval as a good daddy girl, as a good wife. Never searched to have any other opinions. Followed my dad, then followed you. As I played with my dolls, made them have a happy life, you also played with
play?
Me.
Play? What expression is that to use?
I simply mean that I was transferred from my papa's hands into yours, never asked to do anything else with my life, because I would not have been a respectable woman if I tried to do so.
How unreasonable and how ungrateful you are, Nora. Have you not been happy here?
No. I thought it was, but it has never really been so.
Not happy?
No. Only, Mary, you have always been kind to me, but as home has never been anything else than playroom. I was your dolly wife, and the children were my dolls. I loved it when you played with me as I loved it when I played with them, but that's all our marriage has ever been, Tom.
Right. Yeah. to what you say in your exaggerated and strange way. Yeah. But in the future, it shall be different.
Yes,
you are right. Playing time shall be over and lesson time shall begin.
Whose lessons, mine or the children's?
Both yours and the children's, my darling Nora. Hmm?
Yes, yes, you're perfectly right. I want to become an adult, a responsible person. I want to learn about life, and life shall teach me. And you're not the man to help me with that. And that's why I'm going to leave you now.
What did you say?
I have to make some sense out of this.
Making sense out of this? You mean deserting your home, your husband, your children?
I cannot consider that at all. I just know that I have to do this for myself.
Before everything else, you are a wife and you are a mother. Do not forget that.
I don't believe that any longer. I used to. I know that most people would say that you're right and that views of that kind are to be found in books.
You can't judge a book by its cover.
But I can no longer go by what most people say when it's found in books. I must try to understand things.
But what is it that you do not understand? Your place in your own home? Have you no clear guidelines in these matters, such as moral sense?
I just know that you and I look at things in a quite different light. I'm also learning that law is not what I thought it was. According to law, a woman is not allowed to save her husband's life. I cannot believe that.
Nora, no, you talk like a child who doesn't understand the conditions of the world, believe it.
No, I don't understand. And that's why I have to make out who's right, the world or I.
No, Nora, no. You're ill right now, and you're delirious, and you're, I would almost say, out of your mind.
I've never felt my mind as clear as it is now.
And it is with a clear mind that you are abandoning your husband and children.
Yes, it is.
If that is true, there is only one possible explanation.
And what is that?
You don't love me anymore.
No, that's
just it. No, wait, and if you just say it out like that?
Yes, Tom. It gives me great pain, but as I am now, I am no longer a wife for you.
What did change your feelings?
The wonderful thing did not happen. I've been patient for 8 years. This secret has been holding up everything. It was my joy and pride, and I was absolutely certain that when this happened, you would never surrender to this man's conditions. I was sure you would say, just publish the whole thing, and when that was done...
Yeah, what then? When I have exposed my wife to shame and disgrace?
When that was done, you come forward and say, I am the guilty one!
Nora, no. You know that I would gladly work day and night just for you and bear sorrow and want for your sake. But no man would sacrifice his honor for the one he loves.
It's a thing that hundreds of thousands of women have done. I can no longer be your wife.
No, wait, Nora. I feel I have it in me to become a different man.
Yes, if your doll is taken away from you.
No, just don't do it. Don't do it right. Now wait, at least wait until tomorrow.
I cannot stay here anymore. I cannot live in a stranger's mind room.
But why can't we live in this house like brother and sister?
You know that will not last very long.
But someday, Nora, someday...
How can I know? As I am now, I don't know what is going to become of you.
You are my wife, no matter what becomes of you.
As a wife, deserting her husband's house, I free you from all your obligations. In any case, I free you from myself. Here. Give me my ring back. Here are the keys. Mary knows the house better than I do.
Over Nora, shall you not even think of me again?
I shall often think of you, and the children, and this house.
Can I write to you, Nora.
No.
At least let me send you your...
No. I cannot receive anything from a stranger.
Stranger? Am I really nothing more than a stranger now?
Tobin, I don't believe in wonderful things happening any longer. Goodbye.
Thank you.